Making a Stuart Model steam plant. This is part 5. Working on the second of the Stuart Model's S50 steam engines, making a missing part for the crosshead guide, and wondering why the engine runs but doesn't have any power at all. I'm supplying the engine at the moment with about 30 pounds per square inch of compressed air, and when I push the flywheel over top dead centre, it starts to run with about as much power as a Mammod or a Wilesco steam engine. The engine is incredibly weak, it doesn't run well at all. And I can hear that the compressed air is blowing past the valve somewhere inside the steam chest. More about that later. There is a part missing, and it's quite an important part. It's the crosshead guide spacer. You can't see it in this clip for two reasons. One, it's missing, and the other one is the camera angle is obscuring the place where the part is missing from. Here I'm removing the crosshead guide, and this is the part that I need to make. It's a very simple job, so now it's over to the Boxford lathe, and I fitted a piece of 3/16 of an inch diameter steel bar into the chuck. I faced across the front, centre drilled it. Next, I selected a twist drill, which is clearance size for 7BA. Because the top bar of the crosshead guide is held in position using two long 7BA bolts. Once I drilled the hole deeper than I needed it, it was time to part it off. To set the position of the parting tool, I used the original spacer. I parted off the spacer a bit longer than I needed it, because to make sure it's perfectly level, I want to face off the end that's been parted. Waiting a few moments for the part to cool, I picked it up and put it back in the chuck the other way around. Then I used my usual replaceable carbide tipped lathe tool to clean off the front. And now it's exactly the same length as the other one. And here I'm replacing the guide bar using a spacer at each end. To make it clear, the one that I've just made is at the right hand side. Although it really doesn't matter because they are both exactly the same size. Once I'd tightened both of the 7BA bolts and lubricated the parts, I checked it to make sure that the crosshead was sliding okay along the guide, which it was. I tightened all four of the 7BA bolts and everything was fine. In this clip, I'm introducing some oil from my oil can into the steam chest to make sure there's plenty of lubrication in there. Time for a test run to see what happens. In this clip that you've just seen, I turned up the compressed air pressure from 30 pounds per square inch to 40, but the engine still didn't have any power. Time, I think, to remove the steam chest cover and have a look what's happening in the steam chest. Here's a view inside the steam chest, and the valve basically looks okay. It's not stuck onto the crossbar. It looks a long way from the port face, but that's because I've pulled the steam chest out slightly. I removed the bolt securing the eccentric rod to the valve spindle, then I could withdraw the steam chest altogether, and here you see the port face. This does not look right at all. The slight wear marks on the port face make no sense at all. I think it's time to have a look at the slide valve. Well, I must admit, I've never seen this before. The slide valve is unmachined. This is just the rough casting, just as it came out of the box. Stuart slide valve castings generally seem to be quite good. And this one is no exception. All it needs is cleaning up on a surface plate using some wet to dry sandpaper. A bit of dodgy camera work here, my hand is definitely in the way in this shot. But after a while, by using a piece of 400 grit wet to dry sandpaper and some oil, the slide valve started to look a bit better. It's not there yet though, it still needs a bit more rubbing. Here I'm using the figure of eight method, which is the one that proper engineers recommend. I must admit though, I generally do not do that. I just go from side to side across the valve because the rest of it gets smoothed out when it's running. I bought some of this thin gasket paper called Flexoid, and it's quite useful. It's much thinner than the gasket material that I normally use, and it's ideal for smaller engines like this one. I fitted this gasket, then the steam chest, then the gasket that was already there, followed by the steam chest cover. And after refixing the eccentric rod to the valve spindle, I connected the A-line and opened the valve. The transformation was quite amazing. The engine runs fine now. The valve timing was slightly out. I've been very careful not to damage the slot-headed grub screw. I started to adjust the timing. As I was reassembling the engine, I checked that the slide valve moved equidistantly across the ports. The air admission is still a little bit late, but sometimes on these type of engines, it's better to admit the steam or air just before the piston reaches the full extent of its travel at each end of the cylinder. No, that setting's not right, it's too lumpy. I'd like to mention that when you're doing this job, you do not need much compressed air, just enough to hear the hissing noise as the air is admitted and exhausted from the cylinder at each end. I changed the valve setting, but it's still not right yet. It's very easy to get into obsessive mode doing this. I quite enjoy it. And after a while, when the engine runs like this, it's worth it. The engine's not the best sounding S50 I've ever heard, but it's running much better than it did at the beginning of the video. I started to clean up the flywheel using some Scotch-Brite, but then I had a better idea, just run the engine. Running the engine under power and holding the Scotch-Brite against the outer rim of the flywheel cleaned it up. Pity I forgot the edges. It's certainly running well, and it's getting better all the time as the port face beds in. Right at the end of the video, a bolt appeared on the bench, and I was really puzzled about this. Where did it come from? And it was only when I saw the video that I realised what it was. It was the pinch bolt from the eccentric sheave. That's about it from me. All I have to say now is stay healthy, thanks for watching, and I hope you found it useful. Please take the time to visit my main Steam Models website and click on the section of the website that says Video Playlists. And by doing that, you can find other videos that you may like to watch. And by using the playlists, you can actually watch the videos back to back.